In this question, we have to show that the semi-vertical angle of the cone of maximum volume and given slant height is 10 inverse square root 2. So here I have a cone with base radius r, height h, slant height l, and semi-vertex angle theta. And in this, l is given. And from the Pythagoras theorem, I can write L squared equals to R squared plus H squared. And we want to maximize the volume, which can be written as 1 by 3 pi R squared H. And we want to maximize this volume. You note that there appears to be two variables in the expression for volume. However, we can eliminate one of them using the relationship between L, R and H, because L is given, so we can treat that as constant. So from this equation, I can write R squared equals to L squared minus H squared, and that I can substitute in my expression for volume. So I get L squared minus H squared into H, or V equals to pi by 3 L squared H minus H cube. And we want to maximize V, and to maximize V, we have to set dV by dH equals to 0. So let's find dV by dH. That will be pi by 3. Here L squared will be treated as constant, so the derivative will be L squared minus 3H squared. And let me put value of L squared from this expression. So I get pi by 3 R squared plus H squared minus 3H squared, that is equals to pi by 3 R squared minus 2H squared. And I have to set that equals to 0. So this gives me R squared minus 2H squared equals to 0, or R squared equals to 2H squared, or R equals to root 2H. And here note that I have ignored the negative solution of this equation, because R and H both are lengths and they will be positive. Now we have to check whether we have maximum or minimum for this value of R. And for that, we'll have to find second derivative of V, and for that I will use this expression, because this one has L and H, where L is constant and H is variable. I should avoid using this expression, because in this expression both R and H are variables. So d2V by dH2 will be equals to pi by 3, the derivative of L squared will be 0 because it is constant, minus 6h. And now, because h is distance, it will always be positive, so minus 6h will always be negative, so second derivative will always be negative. So we will have maximum at r equals to root 2h, and this gives me r upon h equals to root 2. And if I look at my cone for theta, I can write tan theta equals to r by h, that is perpendicular divided by base. So this is equals to tan theta. So from this, I get theta equals to tan inverse root 2.